Are you as hungry to get after it as you are for food? Still digesting the insight of David Coggins. Still thinking about his description of this breakthrough, mental breakthrough. Or his perspectives breakthrough. When he qualified for the Bad 100. In order to qualify, you need to run a 1 mile course at least 100 times in 24 hours. It has me curious as to if I'm calibrated or if I'm calibrating like David Goggins, Simply for Life, in which he said mind, body, and spirit were connected. I remember seeing this dumbass old man. I don't know if it was Italian or Mexican, couldn't fucking tell. My dog was taking a shit. And the dude looks at my dog like, that's disgusting. And right up the street, this one sexy bitch walking her dog. I think it was a pit bull. It looked like a pit bull. Or pit bull mix. Enemies. They're definitely a dog that will fuck you up. That's what she had. And I saw her standing at the corner, and her dog was taking a shit. Oh man, oh, nice piece of grass, nice sunny day, man. It's an awesome shit, man. T-Bone was awesome, and she just. She just carries on and just walks away. I'm thinking, okay, mental reminder there. Don't walk on that side. Don't walk on that corner. At least for 48 hours. Till that shit dries up. But I wonder if she gets past because she has a vagina. went to get some coffee recently. And, I remember seeing this one pretty bitch. Fuckable. I'm thinking, fuckable. What a waste of tits and ass. It's a miserable fucking cunt. Serving coffee, spreading her miserableness, spreading her misery. Again, I'm no jolly fellow on here. I want to say that at least my past is. At least I get on with the fucking day. And keep going forward. Instead of saying, oh no, my past, it butt hurt me, now I'm paralyzed. I'm stuck in the mud. Help. But miserable cunts like that, you know, they can be distracting. I think after you see so many of them, it becomes amusing. But I think if you've slipped on dog shit, slipped in the mud, and it's a rainy day, you found out you had cancer. And Hillary becomes president at the same time. And you meet those motherfuckers, I'm pretty sure it'll get you in an unjolly mode. But just be aware of such garbage. And again, I don't want to be like some of these YouTubers or just people alive or past that give some sort of advice of just focus on the now sort of shit, which I agree with, but I think not Jim Rohn, Dan Penny had said it. Many coaches would tell you how to form or deal with success, but hardly anyone covers failure. And I think when you meet motherfuckers that fail to connect to the moment, thus contaminating you with that, or by example, showing you to. To make you feel as hopeless in the moment. just curious if you're aware of that trap. It's hopeless. What's the point? I'm tired. It's the weekend. I'm not on the clock, so I quit. It's my day off. You don't understand. My vagina. I got sand in my coochie. The battery in my butt plug vibrator is dead. Donald Trump is holding me down. But just as I'm doing here, I'll keep that that sideshow, freak show, in mind, but sort of like nuclear fuel, where highly toxic, it'll kill you, it'll burn, make you melt if you're near it. But just the right use and handling of it. You can use it to power a city, a part of civilization. I believe David Goggins had said to do something that sucks every day so that you don't become civilized. That it's dangerous for a man to become civilized, because then you become weak. And if I'm hungry, as I'm at, so I need to get after the ZM for food. I believe that the answer is only relevant to me, and that the answer isn't just in a few words, but by example, by what can be measured. Get after it, motherfuckers. Trump 2020. Ivanka 2024.